take you with. Want to come? Yes, you do. Alright. So, let's hook you up here. Let's get you seated. Sit right in front of me. How's that feel? Oh, good. Flip you around here, you can see what I'm looking at. Here we are, flipped around for your convenience. We're gonna use the dock here to kind of guide us into the water. First, I gotta get my paddle out of the kayak. Remember, I put it in? Alright. I'm thirsty. Before we set off, let's get a drink. No, I normally don't do this, but would you like a drink? Okay. There you go, now we're all set. Alright. Get that water wedge down. Striping on the front. I did that today. Okay. I think I need more new clasp. There's something moving over there in the water. Difficulty with my oar right now. It was lashed behind me to the kayak. It's kind of pulling on me. I didn't like it. So I'm going to bring it forward. Lash it in front of me. There we go. Which is right next to you. And we're going to kayak back. As you can see our landing site. You can see where I put the cart. Nobody's going to do that thing. Nobody's going to look at that and go, oh yeah. I won't do that. Oh, I forgot to put on sunblock. So I'll probably pay for it. One of the things I just forgot. I am filming this with my old Samsung S5 phone. I've completely disabled everything on it, except for, use the rudder. There we go. It's a rudder type thing. Slicing through the water like glass. Don't you love that? Look how beautiful it is out. Oh, it lets me take pictures through my gloves. This is fantastic. Oh, I'm liking this more. So right along here, this is a lot like our pond. A lot of seaweed. And typically when I do these kayaking excursions, I'm quiet because I let you just listen to nature, but today I really need to talk out loud because it's the first time I'm on this lake. Really over here, and I'm very scared of water. So if I talk out loud, I think it will help me a great deal, and I'll feel more calmer. So that's just what I'm going to do. I know it's crazy, a person who's afraid of waters, kayaking. That's why I'm doing it. It's to help me through my fear. Should all try and, not necessarily conquer our fears, but, you know, work with them. Because if I had just let my fear of water just take control of me, I wouldn't have the pleasure being out kayaking. And I do enjoy it. I really do. And I love how this kayak just cuts right through the water. I'm gonna stop you for a second. Just point you right down at the water's edge here. See how we just kind of cut right through. Kind of like a knife. I'm not too concerned about my old phone, you know, falls into the water. I'm pretty concerned about it, so, you know, it's kind of nice to not have a covering on it. And this way, I can, you know, have my other phone on me, fully charged, and I don't have to wonder, you know, about battery life with my phone in case something happens. It's, you know, still got a good battery life. Get that angled up a little bit more. Look how beautiful that is. Oh, so beautiful. Love how I can take pictures. Oh, and it bumped down again, so let's bring you back up there. There you go. It's real pretty over here. I want to get a nice shot. There we go. Hopefully it took that picture. Not sure if it did or not. But here we are, around this side of the pond. And Fox River is over here. And I'm not exactly sure which way it goes. I know there's one that kind of winds in both directions for a little bit. One goes to Spring Lake, I believe. So here's an area here. I don't know if this is the Fox River. Or if this is just, no, this is just a little marshy area that it goes into, as you can see. I'm going to pivot here. Use my rudder to kind of pivot. Here we go. Just a little inlet, and it gets a little marshy back in there. So, over here, how did I just turn around here? Over here, you can hear me over the water, is the Fox River. More attention to kayaking than staring at the camera. The camera can just sit there. Just saw some things in the water just kind of rustle. This is a motor-free lake. So no motors are allowed on this lake, which is fantastic. Then I don't have to worry about, you know, People speeding by me. This is the fox right here. Oh, there's a couple of ducks. I'm sorry, sweethearts. So this is the Fox River. And this goes to Spring Lake. It actually is pretty wide here. But I've never kayaked on the river, and the Fox River is not a kind river. Let me kind of pivot here. Maybe someday. Alright, let's go down just a little bit. The water is flowing this way. So. Overcoming fears, remember? We'll go down it just a little bit. I wish our channel was like this, that goes back to our pond. It'd be nice, and I could just kayak right out of our pond. Right into Park Lake, but you still wouldn't be able to get the lower lake because we got the dam and the spillway. Yeah, so this is the Fox River. There's another. Look at that. Overcoming fears. Don't know how far down I want to go. It is flowing this way, so I feel better about that now. It's a nice calm day. This is a good kayak, you know. I'm talking to myself. Not be so scared, you know. Camera shakes every once in a while, or you hear me stop because I'm taking a picture. I don't know what time it is, so I'm going to take a little bit of a break here. Check my phone. 4:17. Alright. Because I have to get dinner at 5 o'clock. And I still have to traverse the rest of the pond back there. Lower Lake. We can do it. We're alright. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the thorny crown? Oh Lord, show me the way. Oh sinners, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh sinners, let's go down, down to the river to pray. God answered my prayers. I was going to come down about this far and see how far I could get, and I see now that I can't go any further. Good. There's lots of stuff across the way. I could probably squeak by on the right-hand side there. As we get down here, the lighting will be better. I'll be able to see a little bit better here. Yeah, I'd be able to squeak by good stuff on the right-hand side, but further down it looks like there's stuff. Hoping that I'm catching this on the camera. It's kind of dark, but I'm also wearing my sunglasses, so hoping it's showing up. So, looks like you can go, you know, around it here. But there's more stuff down, as you can see behind there. I don't want to go. Yeah, there's no way. It's all blocked. I could get around it, but then just as you get around the other side, there's tons of stuff. Oh, and it's shallow through here. I can see sand. Okay, calm down, calm down. You're fine. Something's gonna trouble water. Remember all of it. Look over yonder and what do I see? Wade in the water. Holy Ghost coming on me. Wade in the... come on back. I'm gonna get a good picture. Come on back. Swing this way. Swing low, sweet chariot. Come for to carry me home. Here I go. That's a pretty picture, party girl. Swing low, sweet chariot. Come for to carry me home. I listen to music while I'm out here. That would be silly though. Oh, pardon me, excuse me. That was a bad burp. Another good picture, come on. There we go. This phone's actually doing pretty good. I'm actually pretty proud of it. So, now that I know that I can get down to the end of here, any further, I feel much better about it. Alright, now that we're going good here, I'm going to stop and I'm going to flip you around. Hello. Back we are. Let's go over that down course here. You can see the Fox River that we're on. So a couple days ago, I kayaked to Park Lake, and so now I'm on Lower Lake, so-called Spring Lake, I think? I've never called it Spring Lake, though. If you look on a map of Party Boat, though, it says Spring Lake. Just silly. So... take a selfie. You could probably get a still off the camera. Alright. So Fox River is behind us and now I'm going to flip you around again, so pardon me for just a moment while I stop this and flip you. And we are back. And we are headed towards the shore. There's good old Partyville coming into view. Let's get a nice picture of that. And let's zoom in. Go any further? No. That's it. So Carol's Combs is right up there. As you see, there's some vehicles and stuff right there. That's Carol's Combs. Wonderful food. Again, this is me kayaking in Partyville, Wisconsin. Thank you for coming along with me. I was singing for a little while back there just to help me out. Not be so afraid. I know it's silly. So as you noticed from my previous videos, my kayak was red, and today now I have yellow stripes. I added them. Makes for more visibility out here. Kind of a contrast. See what time it is. 4:26. Alright. When you're in a kayak, you do move side to side, but you're stable. See, I'm completely stable. I'm not gonna fall in. As a matter of fact, I can tip pretty far over and I'm not gonna fall in. As a matter of fact, I have filled this kayak full of water in the middle section here and it still floats. So, everything's good. See how those people straight ahead have a pontoon boat, but the sign for Lower Lake, when you come by the dock, it says no motored boats. So, much they could do out here anyway. And I wanted a little bit of a change. You know, it's a little different. Gets me out of my element because I've been on Park Lake. So today I'm doing this. Change your perspective just a little bit. In front of us. Kind of turn here. Tiny white ducks. They go nice and quiet. Oh, there they go. There they go. You see them now. Sorry, sweeties. Working on camera angles and stuff. When I turn it that way, I can't necessarily see what you're seeing. So it's just a little difficult. Try and angle it so you can see some good stuff. little bit more. Here, angle it that way. You're still kind of looking sideways. And I can still see what you're seeing. Okay. We kind of work together on all this. So I came up on Carol's cones. Let's see if we can get a better picture of that. Kind of mucky through here. See all the seaweed? I can't see it. Ooh. Oh, or got stuck on seaweed. There's Carol's cone right up there. This way, so you can see some more stuff that's still way there. I'll let you look at it, but I'm not going to. Something down by the riverside. I gotta learn that song so I could sing it. Actually, it's a good song. Enjoyed my excursion today. Turn you around now. There we go. Easy daisies. Nesting going on right over here, so I'm going to point the camera that way. As I go by, you can watch. You can see the water just teeming. Got that on film. Good fishing area right here. Something happened, so I apologize for the video quality right now. I do not know what's going on. So, all of a sudden it just changed. Just like that. The right amount of time to get everything out of the way. Now, if this video doesn't work, at least I have the pictures that I took. Let's see if I'm gonna get out of here. It's possible. So I came right back through. So I could see if I could get up on the dock here. So we're gonna stop my camera here. Well, I don't know what's going on with my video camera, but here's the dock. And my kayak is, right here. So we're gonna see if we can get out. So I apologize if, this doesn't go right, and I fall in. But my kayak's not running once it's grounded. But because in the laws of physics, you have momentum and you have forces. So momentum keeps you going forward in the direction of travel. But for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So if I push backwards to get out, my kayak's gonna go back. I'm going to go forward, and if I push forwards to get out and I kind of go this way, kayak's gonna go this way, I'm gonna go that way. So we just have to, use the laws of physics here. I'm gonna put my gloves there. There we go, we get more of our shore on the kayak. Well, maybe I won't have to get up here because the ripple's right there. But this is a challenge, and let me see if I can do it. No, it is not possible. We are going out the other way. We are getting our feet. We are not going out that way. There. You can see kayak up here. So should we get down here? So we go with me. Easier to get out, to just step out. I used to be able to get out, but I think I've lost some tone in my legs. So I'm gonna tip you up just a little bit more. you're standing there, I want you to change my shoes. So here's my shoe. These are size 4, 5s and boys. And then these are socks. They're water socks. Let's put you here. All right. And you're gonna go for a ride. Otherwise, I would have had to carry it all the way down there, or drive my vehicle down there, drop it off, and then drive this back this way. Everything got taken care of. Keys on me. Switch my hat. Phone's in a waterproof bag. Phone's out. Alright, phone's out, keys are right here. And unlock. And it's open my Jeep. Here we are. So, where to put you? I can actually put you like anywhere. I want you to have a good perspective. Putting this in the back here. So let's see how you sit here. I don't know how long that's going to last. Some glass with the little clippers that this thing has. made up something. Hold it. I'm thinking I can still get out here. Really nice to you. Really nice ones. The reason why I'm doing it this way is I broke the tabs that release the ratchet system. Still learning. Maybe this way. There you go. I'm all done. So again, Partyville, Wisconsin, Lower Lake or Spring Lake. Been here for almost 33 years. Whole life. It's always been called Lower Lake. Alright. Yeah. So, off I go. Ta-ta!